All the cells are derived from a totipotent cell, the zygote. All blood cells are derived from pluripotent cells. Pluripotent stem cells divide into 5 discrete unipotent stem cells. Those are erythrocytes, granulocytes, lymphocytes, monocytes, and platelets. Today we're going to talk about the morphology of stem cells. You're going to learn about the definition of a stem cell, the types of stem cells, the difference between the embryonic stem cells versus adult stem cells, and morphology of stem cells. What is a stem cell? Stem cells are immature cells, capable of dividing and self-renewing. They are unspecialized. They have the potential to become specialized into different types of cells. There are 3 main types of stem cells: totipotent stem cells, pluripotent stem cells, and multipotent stem cells. The zygote is a totipotent stem cell. Embryonic stem cells are pluripotent. They can be grown easily in culture media, but they have high transplant rejection rate. These cells are used in in vitro fertilization in clinics for research. Adult stem cells. These are multipotent stem cells. They are undifferentiated cells found among differentiated cells in a tissue or organ. Their role is to maintain and repair tissues, but they are limited to differentiating into cell types of their tissue origin. Adult stem cells have a low rejection rate, unlike embryonic stem cells. There are 3 types of adult stem cells: bone marrow stem cells, neutral stem cells, epithelial stem cells. It's difficult to obtain embryonic stem cells. However, adult stem cells can be programmed to an embryonic stem cell-like state by having them express the genes and factors necessary to maintain the properties of a stem cell. These cells are called induced pluripotent stem cells, haemopoiesis. Like I said in the beginning, all blood cells are derived from pluripotent stem cells. They divide into 5 different forms of unipotent stem cells. These unipotent stem cells are not readily histologically distinguishable. They divide and differentiate and give rise to mature cell types which are distinguishable. The rate of division is determined by erythropoietin, interleukins, and colony stimulating factors. Let's take a closer look at the differentiation of these stem cells. In the bone marrow, we have these multipotent stem cells which divide into myeloid stem cells and lymphoid stem cells. Myeloid stem cells further divide into 4 types of cells: myeloblasts, monoblasts, erythroblasts, and megakaryocytes. Myeloblasts give rise to granulocytes, monoblasts give rise to monocytes, erythroblasts give rise to erythrocytes, and megakaryocytes form platelets. Granulocyte precursors. Myeloblasts divide into neutrophil myelocytes, basophil myelocytes, and eosinophil myelocytes. Neutrophil myelocytes are large, have an eccentrically located nucleus, and have prominent Golgi apparatus. Their cytoplasm contains prominent acidophilic granules. Neutrophil myelocytes further divide into neutrophil metamyelocytes. These have a relatively smaller nucleus with an indentation. The acidophilic granules are no longer visible. The metamyelocytes develop into a stab cell, also known as a band neutrophil. These can be identified by the presence of highly segmented nucleus. Anatomy professors love to ask about these minute details, probably just to make our lives miserable. Try to keep them in mind. Megakaryocytes. The megakaryoblasts we talked about earlier, they develop into megakaryocytes and then into platelets. Megakaryocytes are large cells with large irregular multilobular nucleus, no nuclei, no nucleoli. Their cytoplasm is filled with basophilic granules. The cells do not have a clear margin. The cytoplasm is divided into 3 zones: perinuclear zone, intermediate zone, and the marginal zone. The perinuclear zone consists of Golgi, rough endoplasmic reticulum, centrioles, and the spindle. The intermediate zone consists of interconnected vesicles, and the marginal zone, which contains the cytoskeletal filaments. Megakaryocytes finally develop into platelets, which are the disc-like non-nucleated fragments. There are about 200,000 to 400,000 per microliter of blood. Their lifespan is about 10 days, after which they are destroyed in the spleen. The process of formation of platelets is known as thrombopoiesis. The process of formation of granulocytes and monocytes is known as myelopoiesis, which we talked about to some extent in the video. The process of forming lymphocytes is known as lymphopoiesis. The formation of red blood cells is a whole other topic which we will probably discuss in another video, because this video is getting too long. Alright, for all of you who made it this far, thank you so much. If you like this video, click the like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, check out my channel and subscribe. and follow me on Instagram where I post all of these drawings and notes.